Is it streaming on the stream?
It's still connecting.
Sure.
Okay, we can go ahead, sir.
Right. So good afternoon. Welcome again for this webinar conducted by the Orthopedic Research Education Foundation and Ortho TV. Today we'll have Dr. Arvind Prasad Gupta. He's going to talk to us about basics of arthroscopy and especially about ACL reconstruction. So over to you, Arvind. Share your screen.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Share your screen. Yeah.
Should I start?
Yes, yes, sir.
Good evening, everybody. I'll discuss the basic of knee arthroscopy and ligament reconstruction. So arthroscopy start with the positioning. Most of the time it's supine position. And mostly I use tourniquet in all of my cases. So position may be your leg maybe hanging to the side of the table or maybe over the table with flex knee. Maybe knee that is going to be operated hanging just in front of another outside. So this position give you the more space, particularly when you want to work on the lateral side, like posterolateral, posteromedial. So after positioning of the patient, let's see the instrument for the arthroscopy. This is the scope. Most of the time it's 30 degree, sometimes 70 degree may be used. So this is the tip and this spread the light in around 30 degree of the area. So this is the 30 degree scope. It may be 70 degree. And after this scope, this gets connected with the light cable, which is the light, which illuminate the intra-articular structure. And when this is up, it means we are viewing the down. And this can be rotated like this. It means we are seeing the up. So direction of this is just opposite to what we see. This may be 3 o'clock. It means we are seeing the 9 o'clock. And this may be 9 o'clock. It means we are seeing the 3 o'clock. And after this, this get connected with the camera, which transmit the image to the monitor. And This having three types of movement. Like this is a forward and backward. This is the rotation. The camera can rotate or light source can rotate. This is the sidewise movement. And this is up and down movement. Usually it's only in millimeter. Pinescope is in knee. About the holding. When you hold from very back of this camera, this will not give very stability. So try to hold with your whole palm and thumb and use your two fingers for rotation of your light cable so that your one hand remain free for the working part. So you can see this rotate the cable. And after all these connections, the focus of this camera.
Arvind, your voice is breaking up. I don't know if it's for everybody. Maybe you should shut off your video. Sometimes it helps.
Voice is okay.
Just continue. Are you switched off your video?
I have switched my video.
Yeah, it's still some.
Now is it okay?
Yeah, it's better now. Okay.
Okay. So about this focus, this looks okay. This should be close. It should be in between. It should not be too close to the object like this, or not should be too far from the object. So next is, after this anesthesia part, 2DK part is on. This is the portals. Next is portal. The marking is very important. This is the patella, and this is patella tendon, and this is tibial tuberosity, and this is joint line. So a standard portal is anterolateral portal, which is the viewing portal, and next is anteromedial portal, which is working portal. Rest may be superolateral, superomedial, posteromedial portal, then posterolateral, then accessory anterolateral, accessory anteromedial portal, which is used for the reconstruction of ACL while reaming the femur, and then the central portal, which is also called as central portal of Iltis. Then about the anterolateral portal, lateral lateral to the patellar tendon. So you can see here, usually this anterolateral portal is met in 90 degree of the knee flexions. And you insert your trocar to the trochlear notch. And once it is in, then you start extending the knee like this. And once 30 degree of extension, 30 degree of flexion is gained, then you start passing your trocar cannula into the supratrochlear part. And here, after full extension, you remove the trocar, then you pass this cannula, a scope and camera in. Then here you can see this water part is very important. Many a time in early times, you just pass the scope and you don't see anything because water is not going. So you check here also, at the same time here also, at the trocar, this QRP part. And after that, you slide your scope toward the medial side in the medial compartment and then start flexing the knee. So now you are on the medial side. So next portal is anteromedial portal, which is location is similar to anterolateral portal. And here you can use the IV cannula or needle to see the trajectory of your portals. And it should not be below the meniscus or at the level of meniscus. It should always be above the meniscus. And here the role of triangulation comes because it's very important to place your needle in the lighted area. When you place here, you will not see your needle. So it's the triangulation which work here. And after making the portal with the knife, you pass hemostat so that your fat part will get separated. And when you pass your instrument, so it will be smooth. Like this, here needle. Here you can see, I am placing needle here and my light source is like in this direction, opposite to that. So I am seeing in this direction. And similar here, you can see that this is the needle where I am seeing. And this is well above the meniscus. This is the meniscus, which is well above that. And under vision, you can pass your scope. So you are not damaging meniscus, no any cartilage, anything there. You can see the knife is coming here. And this is the hemostat, which is dilating the fat pad so that your instrument will not get caught in between. Then next is posteromedial portal, which is very important for removal of loose body from the posterior compartment or reconstruction of the PCL. The landmark of this is semimembranosus, where MCL part will come, and this is the tibial plateau. So usually it is 1 centimeter above the tibial plateau. You can see from the arthroscope in pass your needle and then in the knife. Like in this here, again, you can insert your scope in the posteromedial compartment and then you pass your needle from there. Like this, this is the PCL and this is the femur. You inserting your scope in the posteromedial compartment like this, and this you are in the posteromedial, little bit of flexion and little bit of manipulation required. Now you are in the posteromedial compartment. Then you pass the needle here. Then the knife and your portal is met. Then you pass your all the instrument from this. Here you can remove your loose body, your PCL reconstruction, posterior part of the medial meniscus. Like this is a case, this was a case of ramp lesion there. This is the ramp lesion. Next is superolateral portal. Again, around 2.5 centimeters superior to the patella, to the superolateral part of a superolateral corner of the patella. And this can work as a viewing portal again. Any of the portal can work as a viewing portal. And this portal is very important for the patellofemoral articulation. Like this. Here, needle is there. You are seeing on the superolateral part. So needle comes here. Then the knife. Then you change the scope to the superolateral portal. So it is working as a viewing portal here. Now this portal is very good for seeing the patellofemoral articulation. So when there is subluxation, dislocation, or any trochlear dysplasia is there, this is the view. This is the portal which give you very good viewing of this superolateral portal. The next is the posterolateral portal. Again, it's the soft spot between the lateral palatal ligament, tibial plateau, and lateral head of the gastrocnemius. Again, this is for the posterolateral portal, same. Your scope is in the posterolateral compartment, then you pass your needle. Your knife. And pass your knife over that. And this knife should be to your handle, because sometimes your knife may come out of handle. So, SA3 anterolateral portal and SA3 anteromedial portal. This portal used for the reconstruction. It's very important to be aware about the collateral ligament, like MCL comes in this direction. So when you do your medial collateral ligament of Gilkes, which is usually around 1 centimeter below the tip of the patella when knee is 90 degree flex. This portal usually used So after this,
your sound in between is giving trouble again and again, yeah?
we moving to the medial joint, then we see the meniscus. The knee get flexed 90 degree, where we give the valgus stress test. So complete the meniscus can be seen on the medial side. Then take the scope little bit back and toward the central part. This is the ACL, very clear view. And this is the PCL. PCL part can be seen. And then you turn your scope sidewise toward the lateral side. This is the root of the lateral meniscus. Here you can do figure of four position to see the lateral compartment in a good way. So after passing through the lateral compartment, you can see the body of the meniscus. Here you can see the popliteus also. Then you come to the lateral compartment. Then lateral gutter. And here you again swipe your scope towards up so that you can again come back to the patellofemoral area, trochlear area. So this was all about the basic part. Here, if any question related to this basic orthoscopy, we can discuss.
So any questions about
that
part?
Yeah, question about the basic orthoscopy, portals.
Jaswinder sir has raised his hand.
So let him ask the question.
Jaswinder sir, please.
Oh, that was by mistake, I'm sorry.
Oh. Any questions from the DNB students? PGs.
So may I
probably they have a problem.
Sir, sound problem or sir?
Yeah, I think that sound problem is something that's come. It proves in between, but in between again it lapses.
Sir, maybe due to video playing in between, sir.
Yeah, that's good. So.
Yeah, it's the internet bandwidth which is the problem, I think. But
sir.
Okay, carry on. We'll see how it goes.
Last we will have to.
Yeah. Arvind, carry on. Arvind, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
so hello?
Carry on. But the problem is that once in every few minutes, your voice kind of gets lost.
Should I continue, sir?
Sorry, yeah, continue. Yeah.
Okay. So in the basics of ligament
in the voice is a problem.
We should make the diagnosis.
It is very poor connections.
Arvind.
So it should start with.
So Arvind, can you hear me?
We have lost him. I mean, he's connected.
Maybe he should try to connect on his phone line. It might be better. फोन से बात कर लेना एक बार.
हाँ सर मैं कर रहा
हूँ. हेलो.
हाँ हाय अरविंद. सो आई थिंक मेबी यू शुड कनेक्ट ऑन योर फोन लाइन.
ओके सर.
बिकॉज़ योर इंटरनेट थिंग इज वेरी प्रोबेबली नॉट क्विक इनफ सो वी हैविंग अ लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स विद द साउंड. जस्ट सी योर फोन लाइन माइट बी बेटर फॉर यू नो. Yeah.
I should use phone for speaking. You mean to
No. Use the internet connection through your phone.
Okay.
Use the hotspot in the phone.
So use the hotspot and connect your laptop to the hotspot. You know how to do that.
I am using.
See, your voice is totally.
Yeah, we cannot hear at all.
So what are you connected to now? Arvind?
I'm just calling.
I'm doing with this hotspot phone hospital.
Okay. Yeah, so you're trying that. Okay, good. Are you connected?
Yes, I'm connected with the hotspot phone hotspot.
That's what you were connected with before or now?
Yes, sir, before.
Okay, so what about your home internet connection?
That was the Jio router somehow, that is not very good.
Okay. So, I don't know, somehow every now and then the sound goes off because the internet is a bit slow or something.
It may be possible if...
Now I should try.
Yeah, okay, try. Yeah, continue, yeah. So share your screen again, yeah?
Yes, sir. Now it's fine, sir.
It's okay at the moment. It's just that in the middle of the talk, it's suddenly we can't make out what you're saying. So anyway, carry on, we'll see.
Basic of the ligament reconstruction, they start with the making a proper diagnosis, which through the history and then the physical examination related to the ACL injury. So this is the anterior door test. The knee is 90 degree flex with finger behind the proximal part of the leg and thumb is anteriorly. Pull the knee anteriorly and looks for excursion of the knee joint. So this is anterior door test. The next is, this is pivot shift test. You can see the knee is in valgus position with a little bit of internal rotation. And when it goes from extension to flexion, at this stage, the knee tibia get reduced because IT band work here. So when there is a deficiency of ACL, the tibia is subluxated anteriorly, but when from extension to flexion at 30 degree IT band work, and this reduces tibia back. And after that, this is the Latchman test. In knee is in 30 degree of flexion. That can be done with one hand thigh and another hand with the tibia, or you can place the patient thigh over your own thigh and then take the leg anteriorly. This is again positive. And then varus stress test and the valgus stress test at 30 degree of knee flexion. This should be done in 0 degree also. Again, this is positive, you can see. The next is the posterior door test. It's again, sag is there and also tibia is moving posteriorly. This is the dial test for the posterolateral corner. In posterolateral corner, many a time this question has been asked for this PGs. This is formed by this lateral collateral ligament. This is popliteus tendon and this is popliteofibular ligament. So all these three things make posterolateral corner. When only this, the fibular collateral ligament is torn, then varus stress test will be positive at 30 degree. But when this popliteus and the popliteofibular ligament is also torn, then in 30 degree of the knee flexion, look for the rotation of the leg. And if it is rotated to the normal side, then dial test is... Again, this can be done at 90 degree. If again, rotation is more to the opposite side, then this test is positive. PGL. The next is graph lateral tendon and the iliac also. So there is advantage of hamstring over the bone patellar tendon, like anterior knee pain. At the same time, the thickness of this graft in comparison to patellar tendon is less. So I'll discuss one patient. This was the case recently done accident. You can see ACL is injured. At the same time, you can see that posterior horn is, this is the bigger picture. You can see the posterior horn of lateral meniscus is torn. So tendon harvesting should be done according to the preference, hamstring or BPTV. So here you can use the probe to look for whether they will. If it is like this, was coming into the joint, this is going through and through. So this type of meniscus is unstable meniscus. So this was the ACL reconstruction and the meniscus repair. So this is the lateral meniscus, anterior horn of lateral meniscus, and this is the lateral tibial spine. And it should be in the line of this anterior horn of the lateral meniscus, or 7 centimeter from the peak, or in between the lateral tibial spine. This was the previous remnant. After drilling with the guide wire, you hold with the So this was the rima.
Arvind, again, there's too much disturbance. I think people are not able to follow properly. So I don't know whether we can continue like this.
So the accessory anteromedial portal, which I discussed, use for this the femoral footprint. This would be low. This was the area for the ACL footprint. So ACL footprint was identified and guide wire was passed. And this, once guide wire is passed, then the reaming of the lateral condyle. This is the reamer used for reaming of the lateral femoral condyle. And here we can see the depth, what is the length of the femoral condyle with this reamer. So this reaming that the reaming with the graft reaming done, this is the tunnel which is posterior, and the
Arvind, your sound is just going off every now and then, so I think people are not able to follow properly.
That's true, sir.
So should I stop?
Yeah, I mean it's just it's not coming through the way it should, and so whether it's I don't know what I think it's you need to check with the people who are watching, because if they don't get the drift of it, it loses the purpose. Yeah, so maybe we should go to a discussion and then see what people say.
Yeah.
So I get the impression that most people are not able to follow it. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, there is a lot of problems, sir. Connection.
Sir, not audible at all.
Yeah, so Arvind, I think maybe we should reschedule it, and you need to find a stable internet source to do it, because...
Sorry, sir.
No, it's not. I mean, it's...
Three days earlier, there was a meeting, everything was fine, similarly, same thing.
I know, it's just, sometimes it just varies from one time to another, and it's not always predictable. So, Ashok, you there? Probably not. So maybe we can just take some questions and then probably reschedule this when... we have a better line, yeah? Janki?
Yes, sir. So, sir,
we need to deal with that, yeah?
Start the video.
Okay, so I think any questions on what we've had so far, we can take that and then plan it when we have a better connection, because this way. Yeah?
Sir, good evening. I had a question on the clinical examination part.
Yeah, sure.
Yes, sir. Sir, in the Slocum's maneuver, Slocum's modification, wherein we rotate the leg by 15 degree internal rotation and 30 degree external rotation to check for anteromedial and anterolateral instability. In some books, it is written that the front movement 15 degree internal, 30 degree external, and some I find that they have written both 15 degrees. So, what is the correct angle by which we should rotate the foot internally or externally to check for anteromedial and anterolateral instability?
Arvind, do you want to answer that?
You mean to ask about the Slocum test?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
The degree of rotation that you need to do it at, which apparently is different in different books and articles.
So basically, Slocum test is basically for the anterolateral rotatory instability. Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
So, this can be done at the knee flexion angle at 30 degree, 60 degree or 90 degree. Hello?
Yeah, we can hear.
Yeah, so this can be done at all the three angle.
No, but you want to know the amount of rotation.
Amount of how much rotation it should be there for making the test positive?
Yeah. No. Amit, you want to ask the question again so that it's easy?
Like in, for example, for testing the anterolateral instability, we internally rotate our leg in the Slocum's maneuver. Right, sir?
Yeah.
Yes,
it
sir.
So, it should be 30 degrees.
30 degree internal rotation.
30 degree of internal rotation, yes.
And what is the knee flexion angle, sir?
It can be done at 30 degree of knee flexion, 60 degree of knee flexion, and 90 degree of knee flexion.
And sir,
all the three degrees of angle has been described. The
significance of these angles of knee flexion, sir, like what if it comes at 30 degree, what if it comes at 60 degree or 90 degree?
This has been...
Losing you again.
I mean, all the three angles.
I think we need to just do this again because it's just not working out, okay? So I'm sorry.
36 terminal rotation of the leg.
Yeah, I think Hello? The sound, is, Arvind, your sound just goes off in the middle. So I think maybe we should just do this another time, okay?
Yes, very unstable today.
Yeah. Okay, sorry guys, I think we have to just abandon this today's thing and we'll do it again maybe. Janki, you can try and figure out tomorrow or day after, whenever. Okay?
Sure. Yes.
Okay,
sir.
Okay, because this is not working. Okay, bye.
Thank you.
Sir, bye.
Sir, hello. Hello. हाँ सर ये तो आवाज नहीं आ रही थी एक बार अशोक सर को नहीं नहीं मैं एक बार अशोक सर से बोलता हूँ स्ट्रीमिंग ऑफ कर दें हाँ सर वो स्ट्रीमिंग ऑफ कर दीजिए सर चलिए